Hi everyone, this is Tammy at Snowstorm Crafts, and if you're new here, welcome. And if you've been here before, welcome back. So today I want to do these cute little booklet flips with you guys. Just some little booklets made out of some scrap papers and some grunge papers I did with you guys the other day. I put that link on the end screen if you guys want to check it out. Just some fun grunge papers that I showed you guys how I did them and got them ready for my signatures. And then these are some cutoffs from it, and I love to just use up scrap papers and all that and make them into little booklets, little flips. We'll also take an envelope top and make that to help flip that, and it's gonna be great. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do all this, and yeah, so let's get started here. All right, so I'll go ahead and show you guys this one first. So what I did is I have just a piece of, it was a magazine page, and I took the shine out of it, and I have a solution, the little glue, water, and I will, I add a little bit of baby powder or cornstarch. And if you guys want the measurements exact for that, I will post the playlist. I have a playlist that I'll put on the end screen, and you guys can come check it out. It's how to take the shine out of magazine pages and calendar pages and just different shiny things like that. And it works really good. But I have the exact measurements in one of those videos. So you come check out the playlist. It's pretty informative. If you guys want to check it out, they're pretty fun. So what I did is that, took the shine out of it. I had a envelope, a top of my envelope left over, and I decided to go ahead and sew it all around. So I just did some sewing, just some interest sewing, and went ahead and sewed it on here, and made it so it could go on the edge of a journal, and I'll show you guys that in a minute, and it could do a flip. So I made this into a little booklet. I had some extra, this is all just scraps and leftovers. I just dug through all my scraps. Like you can see, this kind of got all muffled and messed up when I ran it through my printer with my deli paper. And it kind of just got all a little bit messed up. So I went ahead and just glued it down, but it looks kind of cool. I think it's neat. So I took my glue stick and glued it down and then did some sewing around it. If you guys want to see how I take my deli paper and print it, and print off images on it, I will try to remember to post that on the end screen. If I forget, remind me in the comments, you guys. Yeah, that really helps me out, but I'll try to remember to post that so you guys can check that out. So I did that, and then I went through and found a bunch of fun just scraps here. And this one I thought would be fun because it's Halloween-ish here. It's just some orange Rit dye, and I dyed lined paper, you can see. And this is just a scrap that I had sitting in there for a while in my scraps. And I always was like, man, that's too bright. But I just thought it'd be kind of fun, for example, here. So that's with my Rit dye, which is, I've showed you guys before, but I'll show you again. It's just a concentrated liquid that you can dye papers, fabrics, different kinds of anything porous that'll accept it. Works great. So this is like concentrate liquid that you water down and do dyeing with. So it's pretty fun. So I did that, made it orange. I think it was my sunshine orange is what that one is. And I just got some of my deli papers here, some tea dyed papers, coffee dyed papers. So just like that. Some avocado dyed music paper. So that would be fun like that. And then some painty papers, just my deli painty papers. And if I remember, I will put that on the end screen so you guys can see how I did the deli painty papers. They're pretty fun to do. They're great to use in just different projects and stuff. Okay. So we'll just do that. And I just go ahead and bind it in. So let's just stick it all together like that. And for a no-sew option, I wanted to show you guys. if you do not have a sewing machine or do not want to bind it, you know, with twine or, you know, something like that, we can staple it. So this is just a packaging, like a spongy, squishy packaging. And what you could do here, and I like to, let's go ahead and clip, oh, that might be too small. Just to clip it in place here so they don't go wiggling around. And I'm just grabbing random things that are close to me here to clip it down. So it doesn't really matter here. Okay. And you're just going to want to set it down on your foam piece. Like that. Open up your stapler. And I think I'm going to do it 3 times. So push it here, just like that. And these are just regular staples, nothing fancy. Okay, so you just, whoops, I mean to bump everybody. Ooh, getting nuts around here, throwing things around. Okay, so you did that. Then take, anything would work. Take your pokey tool, tweezers, into your scissors, just some scissors, anything like that. Pop this up because it was stuck into there. So that's why you get the pokey prongs like that. See them sticking out. Okay. And we're just going to take it. Like I said, you can use your scissors. So you're just going to want to push down. Like that. There we go. Use a pokey tool. So I'm just pushing them down. Just like that. We are bound in. Okay, so that's definitely a no-sew option that you could do. And you got yourselves a little booklet here. Just like that. Okay. So that's kind of fun. Now, we'll take our journal. Any old journal will do. And then you can go with the orange theme here. So you can take it and glue it like that. Just glue it down to the page like that and then have a flip out. So it's glued. You just put glue on this side and you go like that. Or you could go to the other side of the page. This, put glue here and do this side of the page like that, and then have a flip out like that. So either or. And another fun little thing you could do is you can have a tuck on this side, so you could just put some glue here and here and glue it down, and then you can have a tuck here like that, and then it will flip over and you can close it like that, just like that, and then you have a little tuck. So that's a fun little option. So keep the tops of your envelopes, if you have an envelope that's too tall or cut it off or, you know, whatever, just keep these are nice little flaps that you can add to a booklet. Okay, so that's definitely one option. Now let's see. This is just a booklet option where I just added some fun little things in here, and they're just all scraps that I had hanging around that needed to go into a spot. So it's just kind of fun, and it's just a fun little scrap thing that you could put into your journals and you know, have journaling spots. Okay, so I'll show you how to make this little booklet. So it's pretty much just take your, whatever you're gonna use. And I just did some decorative sewing around it and just kept some fun little threads on it. Okay, so we do that and take some lace, any kind of lacy, fun little fabric. You can put fabrics, anything you wanna do. Just some stamped on deli paper, some eco prints, some craft paper. I mean, whatever you got here, it all works. And some avocado dyed paper like that. And I'm just lining it all up and some parchment paper. Gotta have the crinkle. Okay. And then go like this. And now I'm going to go to my sewing machine and just run a straight stitch right down the middle. So you can clip this if you want into place so it doesn't move. And then I'm just gonna go to my sewing machine and start down at the bottom or start at the top, either way, and just sew it right down. Do a back stitch at the top and the bottom just to secure it in there. So I'll do that and I'll be right back. That is all stitched together, just like that. Just a straight stitch in the middle. And then now, if you don't want all this sticking out like that, or you know, as much, we can do this. I like a little bit of it sticking out, just a little staggered. Kind of a waterfall effect, if you will. Fun little thing you could do. So that's another little booklet, just like that. This one is super cute. So this is just a flip that you can do where it can go into the journal like this and be clipped in or tucked in or glued in. But here, I'll show you. Okay. So you got the outside here, just like that. And whatever cover you want to use, just any scrap paper or any kind of cardstock. This is just some of my digitals I have on the other side. And I took a napkin and just decoupaged it down. Okay, so what I did is I took a piece of lace and just sewed it for the edging here. Just a little zigzag stitch. And you just fold it down like this. And I'm making this one a little shorter, so it's easy to go and flip it open, okay? So there we go, and you can even take your phone folder, give it a good fold. All right. And then we just start stacking it with our scraps here. So this is definitely a scrap buster. Okay, and I got some coffee, marbled paper. Line it up where you want them. I think that looks great. I like the layers kind of sticking out at the bottom. And I'm just going to open it up and do the same concept. I'm going to go ahead and go over and just do a quick sew down. And I'm just going to go down and backstitch and backstitch and do a straight stitch. So I'll be right back. So I went ahead and just stitched it in the middle. Okay, so this is what we got so far. Okay, and I'm going to pop an eyelet in there. And then flatten it, just like that. Okay, and then I just have a little bulb pin with some beads on it, and then I put just a decorative little flower. And I think this will work. Hopefully the flower won't be too much. But I think I can pop it in there. Might not work. Hold on just a second. Let me find something else. I'll show you guys what I came up with. So I just took a piece of tea dyed fabric and I slit at the end like this on this end and then ripped it and tied it around the bowl pin. And I'm gonna do the same here. I'm just kind of making this up as I go. Let's see, hopefully it'll rip. Okay, give it a good rip here. Ah, look at that. And then I'm gonna stick it through here. And do a little knot. Oh, how fun is that? So now you got your bolt pin and some fabric saying, I think that looks great. I think that's so much fun. So that's fun. I just kind of made that one up and just kind of did rips on each end, tied it there and tied it there. And then we get our little bolt pin hanging off. So I'd love to hear in the comments what you guys think of how this is turning out. And if you're liking it, please hit the like button. It really does help me out a lot. And yeah, it gets me out there a lot further. I really appreciate you guys. But there we go. So we got the inside of it. We got that. Now I want to decorate it. So what I did is I took a piece of coffee dyed paper and I cut it into just a square. Folded it in half, just where I wanted it. And then I went ahead and took some of the leftover yellow here and just glued it down to each end. Glued it down, and then I put a coffee dyed, it's like a grungy parchment is what it is. I put that down and glued it, and then I took my little gems here, which this is a fun little kit. I love it. And I bought it initially for my, when I was doing dream catchers. I was doing some fun dream catchers, and I wanted some cool little rock gems that I could put through as I was doing that. But, and I ordered this, but the little holes are so tiny. I thought they were going to be a little bit bigger. So these are so tiny, so it's hard to thread anything through it. So I take them and use them and incorporate them into like tabs and top things and different things like that. And you can glue them down. And I just have been using my FabriFix glue. And that works great. And I also have the E6000 stuff. It's great for like little metal pieces and rocks and stuff like that. So the E6000 FabriFuse, this is like extreme strength. I mean, this works really good. But I did it yesterday just with my FabriFix glue, and they're holding great. I mean, they don't seem like they're gonna come off. But if you want just extra security, I would do the E6000. Okay, a little trick right there. So now what I wanna do, as I got this all dry overnight, I'm just gonna take it and I wanna pop it down just like that on the top. I think that would be really fun. So this is a cool little decor. Oh, and I'll make sure, these are my Amazon links, I think, down below, if you wanna check that out, and along with the kit. I have the whole kit here that's down there. Okay, so let's just take this. Okay, and then just glue it down. Isn't that cute? It just kind of all comes together. So that's a fun little booklet. And the best way I can think is, let's see. There's different options that you can do. So you could take it, let's find a yellow page. Just 'cause. Okay, so you can either take it and pop it down, and you could do just a little fun clip like that. So that's an option. On the side like this, and do a little clip. Just put some glue, pop it down, and then it could just stay into your journal and go like this, and you could play with it like that. So there's a couple options to do, and they're just fun little flip up books when using all your scraps up. Okay. This, and this is just a business card that I got in Alaska when I went, and I really thought it was cool. The little sewing machine with the little lady sewing machine doing sewing. I think it's fun. Okay, so I want to incorporate some of the corrugated cardboard behind it like that, but I want it a little bit darker, and I'm thinking maybe some of this packaging. So this is just all scrap stuff that I have. So maybe a little bit of packaging poking out like that and like that. So what I want to do is go ahead and grunge all this up. I want to make it a little bit darker. So let me get set up for that and I'll show you guys how to do that. All right, so I got some scrap pieces here and I just put it down on a piece of parchment paper. So we're gonna make a little mess here. Got some water, a fan brush, gesso and water. It's just watered down gesso. So it's just watered down. Let's see, I got some coffee, instant coffee and glue, instant coffee and water mixture. And then I have some in a spritz bottle here. Same thing, so I can spray it or drip it. Now, the thing is with the coffee, you're going to want to make sure to put a little bit of just some rubbing alcohol, just the isopropyl alcohol. And I just have 50. And just make sure to put like, you know, maybe like a half a cap full or so in there, just so you don't get mold. You don't want the mold to set in. So make sure to put a little bit of alcohol in it. And that helps. And I have some Rit dye, which is aquamarine blue, some black, and some denim blue. So what else do I have? I think that's what I was gonna try to use right now. So let's see. So, okay, so this is what the card looks like. And I think I might wanna splatter a little bit of bright magenta in there. And then I got the blue, I think would match nicely. So I just wanted to bring in a little bit of color. Okay, oh, and what I did is I took my scraps and went to my sewing machine and literally just ran it through. I did different kinds of stitches, not really thinking much about it. Excuse me. Ran it through and just kept them attached and just did that. And then I'm going to grunge them all up, then dry them with my heat gun and then cut them. Or, you know, maybe place them behind. You don't even really need to cut them. So that's just called, it's chain. This is chain sewing. Is what it's called. It's when you just kind of run it through and then slide the other one through and slide the other one through and slide the other without stopping and pulling the thread and cutting it. It makes it so you don't waste your thread. So that was a little fun tip and trick. Okay, so now I'm just plopping all this down. No rhyme or reason. And I just got a little bit of cheesecloth and some laces. I figured since I'm doing this, I might as well throw some scraps down. And we got some scrap papers that we took and ripped from our other little journals. So no wasting here. And let's just do some fun little splattering. See, it's pretty watered down. Okay, so this is just water. And when I put down my black Rit dye, I just went ahead and did a little spritz and it kind of spreads it around really cool like. I also want to throw in, I like the look of this distress oxide. It's just the refill. So this one could be kind of fun just to get it a little darker. Just to do just little splats here and there. So this is something you can definitely do with your scraps and, you know, piece it together. You can even do a collage masterboard with them and then cut them out. And I mean, there's just tons of ideas you could do. Okay, so I think I got everything where I like it. And I want to go ahead. Oh, that looks really cool right there. I'm going to get my heat gun and I'm going to go ahead and dry all this. And I want to show you guys something real quick. So I went ahead and moved all of it over onto a clean or a dry piece of parchment paper so I can heat gun it over there. And then this is what I'm left with. So this is all a bunch of good stuff here. So what I do is I just take my bakery tissue. It's just 1,000 sheets. I have this on my Amazon links, and I love this stuff. It's just, you pull a sheet out at a time. They're 8x10, and I love them. So what I do is you could take your paintbrush and kind of move this over if you need to, just so we don't waste anything here. Okay, and this kind of reminds me of like a jelly plate. When you can just go like this, like that, and just let it soak up what it's gonna soak up. So, and then these are great to use in projects, which you've seen on my channel if you've watched my channel before. Just put these to the side. And you can even add a little bit more, because I don't like to waste any paint or anything, because look at all that. That's still all good stuff right there. You know, and you could just kind of put it where you want it. So I'm just going to do that and set these over to the side and get those dry, and I will be back. All right, so I got everything fairly dry here. It's a little tacky, but that's okay. Now, we got our journal. And so I have a question real quick. If you guys would like to see what a whole video on what I would do with these fun little scrap pieces, let me know. And then I'll make a, you know, we could do a bunch of them, and I have some fun ideas. So comment down below. And if I get enough comments, I will definitely make one, and we could do something really cool for our journals. Okay. So please, yes, comment. I would love to hear from you guys. Okay. So what I got here. So now what I'm going to do is kind of just stack this up and see how it works out. And we could do a little snipping in between. Fun and grungy. I'd love to hear, do you guys like grunge? Is grunge something that you guys like watching and doing in your journals? Or do you guys do more, what's the word? Straight-laced, I guess, more where it's not so grungy. I'm kind of curious. I'm kind of curious what kind of style you guys like to do. I would love to hear from you guys, because I kind of like both. What did somebody say? I posted something, and somebody said that my style is kind of a pretty grunge. And I'm like, oh, okay. I've never heard that before, but I thought that was a fun compliment. I'm like, all right, so I guess that's a style that I kind of have. It's kind of because I like the pretty pinks and blues and stuff like that. And then I love just the grunge look too. So I guess that's I don't know if that's a thing, but I kind of like it. Okay, so I'm just doing that. How to incorporate some scraps, you know, because we all have scraps hanging around. And it's like, what in the heck am I going to do with these scraps? I mean, this could even go on top like that. I kind of like that. Okay. I think I like that. Yeah. And I'm going to just ink around the edges here and get all this glued down. So I think that is so cool. And with her doing it, you know, sewing on the sewing machine, I have sewing all around the background of it all and all the grungy awesomeness. I'll make sure to get a picture of at the end so you guys can see all of it. But there we go. So we got that one done. We did another little booklet, a little flip here. That and then another little envelope side flip. So I think those turned out really cool. So yeah, I would love to hear from you guys in the comments. Let me know if you guys want to know to see what I want to do with these little fun little scraps, and I'll get a bunch more done up and then do some more on the next video with you guys if you want to see it. And then we'll, yeah, let's incorporate these into our junk journal. So please comment below. I'd love to hear from you guys. Okay, so I hope you guys found this inspirational and informational. And if you could please subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell so you guys can see my next video when I post it. Like, comment, share, and let's grow together. And keep on crafting.